Hello there, I'm Björn, and I'm going to talk about inclusion in LARP between challenge and experience of limits. The topics I want to talk to you is about limit of imagination, communication, vision and resources, and accepting the challenge that is beyond the limit. Where are the disabled LARPers? There are probably not so many, or maybe you won't see every disability because not all disabilities are visible. We are there, and we are many. I'm one of the 3% that is disabled by birth, and that is not so many because 1 billion disabled people are in the world. And if we look at the several percentages, you can see that there are some things you won't acknowledge when you are just live your life and go through society as we all do. There's a limit of imagination when we play LARP with disabled people. We succeed in immersion when, in a greater or lesser extent, when it's depending on the situation, the location, the participants, or unexpected events that are occurring in a LARP. But we often portray supernatural beings, and we are good at it, like pretending that we are a wizard. We acknowledge that a person has the aim to present wizarding skills, and we react to it. Also, we know that this is already a break of immersion, because on a meta level, we are fully aware that this is not happening in the real world, and it's all that we are doing for the game. So why then it is a problem when we meet disabled people? One assumption I have is that people that are non-disabled cannot imagine how or when you have limits occurring in your life spontaneously. And this could happen to all of you. People that are non-disabled at this moment are, can have a car accident or something else, and they can be disabled at the very next moment. We make assumptions as people that are non-disabled that we have to make the decisions for disabled people. So we don't communicate this in a really good way. And disabled people often get the feeling that they are not taken into account at LARPs. So why is that? Because we can find the information we need, like location, like the game itself, like participants, or the expectations of designers, and so on. So the effort I have to put and the energy I have to put in going to a LARP is, beside the fact that I'm a disabled person and have to plan the whole journey, I have to ask the organizers what I have to expect from the LARP, from the location, from the game itself, maybe from the participants. And that costs me much, much more energy than all the other people, because the other people don't have to have all these things on top of that what I have. So we want to have informed choices. What are informed choices? You can read that by the NCDHHS on 2023. Basically, it's getting enough information to make a decision that I can cope. So what can we do to solve the problem? Well, that are my personal thoughts about this. Don't make your mind up of my disability. Don't assume that you know what I can do or what I cannot do. Trust me, as any other person on your lab, that I'm well aware that I'm disabled and that I can make my decisions for myself, and not that you as a designer have to make decisions that are probably not the right ones for me. Look at the situations together with me, with us. And stay open-minded that when someone comes to you with a need, that you can solve the problem together and don't assume again that you know everything, because you can't. The world is diverse, and there are so much disabilities that even we as a community of disabled people can say things that goes for another person. Be willing to learn from the people you meet and educate yourself. When it comes to certain situations, in my case, that's more on the intimate level, I need a space and I need a relationship to people I'm talking to, yeah, in order to get them to solve the problem with me together. Because sometimes this could be, yeah, a bit shameful, not only for me, but for the other person too. The other person has to be aware that maybe, I will say it, they have to wipe my ass. And that's not for everyone. Recognize during a play, during a game, there's certain needs that could be physical barriers, that could be distinctive scenes or interactions with other participants that you could not foresee, but you have to solve at the fly. Be not afraid to solve the problem then with necessary knowledge that you get from your players and the calmness you can carry on, and above all, clarity in situations and unambiguity are most important for us as people that have the needs. The limit of vision and resources, this is especially going for organizers and designers. Thus, every event I organize have to be inclusive and diverse? No. But there's a but. There's always a but. When I see inclusion as a hurdle that I cannot make my lab with all the visions I have, then I can say that, and I should say that. I have to face the consequences for that, and probably counterpositions. So be prepared for the criticism that then is going to happen, and do the communication right on a certain level. In Germany, we could say eye level. I don't know if that's the same version in other countries or in English-speaking countries. Accept the criticism, listen to it, and process it. Most important thing is, if my resources are not sufficient, the most important advice is, do not promise something you cannot deliver, because that causes frustration at the very moment. You are going to clash with the people that have the needs, and they will not or cannot solve the problem for themselves. Accepting the challenge is, people with disabilities will not give you a one-size-fits-all answer. What do I have to do to be inclusive? That's a question that you have to ask yourself. Keep in mind that no one of us can avoid of thinking about ourselves in exchange with affected people. So how many people have you met that have a disability? How many people do you have played with? How many people do you help or help maybe in a way that you think that would be a help, but you didn't ask the people itself? When it comes to LARP designers and organizers, they, in my opinion, have to emphasize that disability in LARP is not that a character wears an eye patch to be cool. It's more important for me that the representation of disability is one that is within the world and is happening because we are there. We are still there at the very moment in your LARP, and we are not going away. Because we have the fucking right to live as non-disabled people too. Thank you.